All right, so the whole cage is welded. The roll bar is completely done. I actually had to pop my little Lexan windows out back here to weld the rear brace here, both there and there. And man, we're freaking ready to race. I just gotta wrap the harnesses, bolt the seats down, and I gotta pop rivet these windows back in. The intake is ready to go on the car. I did decide I'm gonna hit it with some of this engine paint, and then I'm gonna end up doing my intercooler tubing and gold too when I'm finished with that. So we're gonna be cleaning all this mess up a lot, and it's gonna look pretty slick when we're done. Got my sweet little paint booth set up in the yard. This is gonna look so good. Race night is on Saturday this week, so today is Thursday, so I got Friday. Today's Thursday, so I got tonight and tomorrow night to have the car good and ready. I'd like to take it back to the storage unit after Saturday when we go racing, so I do have one other project I want to wrap up while I have it here. So I got the intake manifold all painted, and it's pretty much ready to go on the car, and it turned out really awesome. This thing just looks so awesome. I think it's gonna look really cool. We're gonna be getting rid of a whole mess of junk off of this intake manifold. So right now what I gotta do is yank that intake off. Here we're gonna be running a different blow-off valve. We're gonna be getting rid of all these little adapters. These little janky adapters. There's one here, and there's another one right here right before the throttle body. Those are 2 to 2.5 inch adapters that we had to use. And they're very restrictive and they're a big problem. So we're gonna be getting rid of those. First things first, we're gonna pull the intake manifold off. And then I got all the couplers and intercooler tubing. I got the old intake manifold off. The new one we have is off of an L28. I believe it's just a N42 block with a N42 head. So I'm pretty sure it's just off a naturally aspirated regular L28 cylinder head. So I went through and I plugged a lot of the holes that used to be used for emission stuff. I also ground away a lot of little bosses that were all over it, all over the back of it. One of the biggest changes I made was, see on this one we have our EGR, comes off a little part of the intake that sticks off right there. Well, you'll notice that this one that's missing. Basically, the EGR on these is a tunnel that goes down and all the way across and all the cylinders. But on the new one, I cut away where the EGR valve goes and we opened up this channel, totally ground away the whole channel and plug welded all of the little ports that used to go into the intake. Plugged our EGR port, plugged that, and just the whole back of the intake is nice and relatively smooth when compared to the back of this one where you got boss, and all that stuff touches things and gets in the way of things. So really the only stuff we're moving over is our fuel rail, our throttle linkage, and our throttle body. Other than that, the intakes seem identical. I mean, they appear to have the same bore in the throttle opening, they appear to have the same bore on the runners. So, I mean, everything's pretty much exactly the same. So we're gonna swap those things over, and then we're going to see what we can figure out on our intercooler piping. I got everything swapped over to the new intake, and I was just starting to bolt it up, but I just noticed a huge problem that's gonna really throw a wrench in the spokes. So first of all, look how sick this looks. That is so much better. Look at how much room there is. You can like actually see the freaking turbo now. Tons of space. But here's the freaking problem. So on the old intake, see, this is from the engine block, the crankcase, is a breather that goes into a PCV valve that's like located like right about here, or give or take, on the old intake. Well, on this intake, that port is located right here. And you can see I just put a little copper plug in it because we're not gonna be using that. But as you can clearly see, even when this thing's totally bolted flush, that thing is way getting in the way of the outlet of our turbocharger. So what this means is I'm gonna have to grind that totally flat and TIG weld over the hole that it's left that remains. Just gonna put my paint job, but that's just what we gotta do. So I'm gonna try to get that sorted out tonight. I don't have much time, it's pretty late. This could definitely be putting a damper on our plans this weekend, but we'll see how it goes.
I just chopped off as much as I could with the sawzall, and what you see in there now is just this, a piece of this aluminum right here. I just had like this aluminum stripping that I used to plug some of the other holes, and I just grinded and grinded on it so I got it pretty close to the perfect size, and then I just banged it in with the hammer. So that's pretty well plugged right now, but it's definitely not something we can guarantee to be airtight. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to weld that and then grind it as flat as I can, and we'll see if we can work around that turbo. All right, so it actually turned out pretty good. So we're gonna go ahead and send it. The welding went pretty well. I went ahead and just welded the whole surface of it and just built it up pretty good. And then I grounded it down to just try to make it as flat as possible. That's about as flat as I'm comfortable getting. I think we're really gonna kind of have, be in a questionable point of strength if I continue to grind on it. So, cause that aluminum that I use, that this stuff right here, it melts like freaking candle wax whenever it gets close to the arc. So definitely a different melting temperature from the aluminum, the cast aluminum that we're dealing with on this manifold. But hopefully it's gonna hold up pretty well. It looks good, so we're gonna send it. All right, so I've been working on the intercooler piping and kind of just jumped right into it. Don't have a lot of video of the process really. I got a little bit I can share, but so this is what we got so far. So I took all the old tubing off, all the couplers, all the adapters, all the bullshit. There's like 100 clamps on it. It was kind of a mess. So I took all that apart and just started from scratch. And this is the first tube that I've made. This was just a few, 4 pieces total that I welded together. And it's all TIG'd. Needs to be painted, of course, but I'm pretty happy with how it all came out. I'm pretty sure these are airtight. Made some marks on it to line everything up, put some tacks in it, and then just fully welded it. But I'll show you how good this thing fits. So, still kind of warm. So this hooked end here is going to go into the intercooler right there, right into that coupler. And just kind of like twists into place like that here. And then up here in the front, we move this harness aside. You can see this is our 90-degree elbow that comes right off the turbo. And this is just gonna fit right in there like that. It's all kind of kinked up right now, but it actually fits pretty good. I've already test fit it. And so, yeah, so this is gonna, so this tube sits in there just like that, goes around our coil location, up and through the hole here and into the intercooler, and that all fits really nicely. Now for my throttle body down to the spot here, I basically had to put 290s together, which I've been working on here. So one of them was already on the car, the other one I chopped up to the right length. And all I'm doing is just putting a little mark like that where they need to be lined up and welding them together. And so that little S shape there is just gonna come out here, go down, and right into there. Real simple. But this is the stuff I was trying to get rid of right here. We had these pieces of junk in there this whole time, and it's just, it's real angular. You know, it's not a smooth transition at all. And it's definitely, that hole there, right here at the end, is smaller than the diameter of the throttle body. So it was actually, not only was it not smooth, but it was also working as a choke point. So this way we're just kind of making everything smoother. There's less hard angles in it. As far as this tube here, it's almost straight, really, all the way in. And then the one coming out before, the pipe went all the way and like touched the radiator. So like hard turn and then another hard turn. But now, although it's still gonna make 2 turns, it's like smooth, it's real fluid. So we're definitely gonna get better flow here. And I'm gonna get this all painted up and looking pretty before I call it totally done, but we may be racing with it looking like this because, man, it's already after midnight. And all I gotta do is put the ports for my vacuum ports for the Megasquirt input and the boost gauge input and the fuel pressure regulator, which is just easy, easy, pilly little shit. So really very close to being totally ready to go racing tomorrow night. Blow test, but just together, it's probably airtight. I bet it's airtight. So I got everything pretty much done. I remembered when I was getting ready to close up shop last night that I had not installed the blow-off valve into our new charge pipe. But I had to weld an adapter to the charge pipe to bolt on the blow-off valve. So I got that welded up and everything plugged in. I gotta figure out where I'm gonna get my vacuum references from. That, and we need to wrap our harnesses on the harness bar. But I didn't end up getting done with the car until about 2:30 in the morning, and now it's 7 o'clock and I'm heading to work. I'd also like to make like a quick parking lot hit and make sure we know where our boost is going to be at, because we've changed a lot with the intake and the charge piping. Alright, so I'm off work now and I'm heading to the track. So I've got some time at work to finish up the vacuum hoses and got the harnesses tied up to the roll cage. before putting it back on the trailer, I wanted to just make a quick rip in my shop's parking lot and just see what kind of boost it makes. As soon as the turbo spooled up, it went into boost cut. So turned down 3 pounds and still hit over like 22 pounds. So even after taking 3 pounds out, we still made 22 pounds. So that is a testament to how much difference it made to do that new intercooler piping. It means we got rid of that much restriction in the intake tubing. You know, I didn't change anything. So the fact that the car is now making 4 or 5 pounds more with the same boost regulator settings, well, that tells me that that air is not getting clogged up in that tubing anymore. But it's raining now, so I got some concerns whether we're even gonna be racing tonight. Well, I just got the word the track was rained out. And it's not even raining out here anymore. It's totally like blown through. Super disappointed. I mean, I was cramming the past 2 weeks. I was just totally determined to get it done. And I've barely been sleeping as a result. And it's not gonna happen.
So I'm gonna get the charge pipes all sanded down, smoothed out, and get some paint on them.
Just gonna get it, kind of take the shine off of it. And then give it a good acetone wiping, and then we're gonna throw some paint on it.
I got the charge pipes all painted up. They look pretty good. Just did a quick rattle can job on them. But I love that color. It looks pretty sick. It's real Z-ish, real 80s. It's gonna match my intake pretty good. And of course the car.